Below is the graph of a polynomial function. Which statement is true? Well, first of all, read the statements and identify the key terms. The key terms are leading coefficient, zero, degree, and turning points. So we'll want to pay careful attention to how those terms relate to the graph as we go along. First of all, recall the standard form of a polynomial function. It looks rather intimidating, but all it is a sum of terms where each of those terms has a real number coefficient and a whole number power of x. When we arrange the powers from highest to lowest, the first term is called the leading term. Its coefficient a sub n is called the leading coefficient, and its exponent n is called the degree. In order to determine whether the leading coefficient is positive or negative, we can look at the right end behavior of the graph. At the right end of the graph, we see that the y values are decreasing without boundary as x increases without boundary. Symbolically, we write f of x goes to minus infinity as x goes to infinity. Now, as x goes to infinity, all these smaller powers of x are going to become relatively small, and it's going to be the leading term that dominates. So all we need to do is investigate what happens to the leading term as x goes to infinity. As x goes to infinity, the x values are positive. And when we substitute positive values for x and raise them to the n power, regardless of whether n is even or odd, the result will be a positive value. However, f of x is going to minus infinity. So we know that after we multiply this positive value by the leading coefficient, the result will have to be a negative number. But we know that a negative times a positive is negative, so that tells us that the leading coefficient is negative. We can now eliminate choice A. The leading coefficient is not positive. The leading coefficient must be negative. The next term we encounter is zero. A number z is a zero if f of z is equal to zero, or equivalently, z is an x-intercept of the graph of f. So what we want to do is to identify the x-intercepts of our graph. The x-intercepts are at negative 2, 0, 1, and 3. So that means that the zeros of this function are negative 2, 0, 1, and 3. 4 is not among the zeros, so we can eliminate b. For part c, we've already identified that the degree is n. But to determine the minimum degree, we need to look at the number of turning points. And turning points is the key term in part D. So let's do part D, and then we'll come back to part C. The turning points correspond to the places where the graph changes from increasing to decreasing, or vice versa. In other words, the turning points correspond to the local maximum and local minimum points on the graph. So we have one turning point here, another one at the bottom of the valley, and another one at the top of the hill. And we see that we have three turning points. Since there are three turning points and not four, we know that D is not the correct answer. And obviously, all of the above statements are true is false, so we can eliminate E as well. C must be the correct answer. But why is that? Well, recall that the number of turning points is less than or equal to one less than the degree. Well, let's add one to both sides and see what that tells us about the degree. We find that the number of turning points plus one must be less than or equal to n. In other words, the degree must be at least one more than the number of turning points. We found that there were three turning points, so that tells us that the degree has to be at least 3 plus 1, or 4. The minimum degree of the polynomial is 4.